Do you think astrologists, palm readers and the like can really tell everything about you? That your personality can be read from your birth date, your hand, or from sensing vibrations? Very possible. As ever, the volunteers here have no idea of what we're about to do. I'm going to ask each of you to take a sheet of paper and to draw around your hand on the paper, that's what the pens are for. And when you've done that, to write on the paper your birth date, and if you know it, your time of birth as well, be very useful. And thirdly, to take some personal object that you have on you. Please don't choose anything that is immediately recognizable as being yours. You're going to put them into one of the numbered envelopes. It does not matter which one. Does that kind of make sense to you all? All right, okay, I will look the other way. If you can do that for me now, that would be great. Any bit of paper, obviously, any pen, any envelope. Put your birth date on the paper into any envelope you like, along with some personal item, please. All done?
Yes.
Can I get somebody just to mix up all the envelopes and hang on to them so that person has all five envelopes as well? Remember your numbers, please, because that's the only way you're going to be able to identify the correct envelope later on. And I will come round now and talk to you. Excellent. Thank you. Okay, so each envelope has a drawing of a hand and a birth date and a little object. I will take these envelopes away and I will try and write a description of the personalities of the owners of those things. Okay?
Cada sobre tiene un papel con su objeto personal y en el papel está una mano trazada y su fecha de nacimiento. Él se va a llevar los sobres. Y de acuerdo con lo que él vea dentro de los sobres, pues va a hacer una descripción de su personalidad.
While I go and do this, we've got a place for you to sit down. We've got some refreshments there, some tea and coffee, paella. And I will come back in and we'll see how it goes. It'll probably take me about an hour to do this. And I will try and be accurate. I'm not going to be general. I'm going to try and be very specific about things. So bear with me and I'll see you in a bit. Okay? All right. Cheers. Hello, I finished. So, if you can each take your envelope, if you can remember your numbers. You're going to go away and read this now. I don't want you being able to read each other's, though. It's very important you kind of only focus on your own one. Really try and spread yourselves out around the room so you're not able to see each other's. And then we're going to ask you individually what you make of it. So go do that. See you in a minute. Thank you.
I was very overwhelmed when I read the analysis. Darren mentioned that, of course, I'm very self-critical, so reading this sort of thing was very difficult for me anyway. It's unbelievable. I can't believe how accurate it is.
I kept reading through the paper or saying, I can't believe he's analysed me so accurately.
It does feel actually so personal. It's actually quite hard for me to share.
Help yourselves.
I feel like it pretty much summed up who I am. The part about self-examination, I think, like, which was in the first sentence on the page, I feel like, oh yeah, that's me.
It's kind of astounding. I've always believed in something like it. This just kind of confirms it, but it also shocks me because I didn't think it would work so well.
It's true. Like, all this stuff is true. I don't get stuff done because I don't like the idea of mediocrity, and that's so true. That's it right here. What the heck? It's so weird.
It was shockingly accurate. Very likely this will lead you to having considered writing a novel, but the fear that you won't be able to achieve what you want stops you from getting it done. And I actually started writing a novel when I was 17 and had written several chapters but didn't finish it because, I don't know.
Ha visto cosas que ni siquiera yo había visto de mí misma.
Nunca había hecho antes algo como esto. Y pensé que iba a ser un poco más general, un poco más vago, un poco más tipo horóscopo y tal. Y realmente va a cosas profundas de mi personalidad, ¿no?
Le daría el 75%, pero el 25% no importa, porque el 75% ha sido tan exacto y tan personal.
Un 80%.
porque hay cosas que están clavadas, que es perfecto.
90% puede ser.
I would give it the reading a 95% accuracy rating.
85%.
Like 40%.
85%.
90%.
99%. Definitely.
Okay. I want to try something else. First of all, if you can all take your readings out of your envelopes and just hold on to them but fold it up, please. Just the readings, not the hands and so on. Thank you very much. This may sound a bit frightening for some of you, but don't worry about it. Can you just mix them up and pass them around so you don't know whose you've ended up with? What I'm going to ask you to do in a moment is to have a look through the reading that you now have in your hand and see if you can identify the person that it belongs to. Can you open this up now and just have a look? If you've got the same one again, just mix them up again and take someone else's.
Everyone got their own.
Right, start again.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, in fact, you have all got exactly the same reading.
Oh my God, that's insane.
Yeah, they are all exactly the same.
Las lecturas personales todas son exactamente igual.
They are all exactly the same.
Stupid.
Please don't feel stupid. This is a skill, it's something called cold reading. It's a technique used by people who claim to be psychic, people who claim to talk to the dead. It's as old as the hills. And if you think for a moment, actually, of how even more effective it would be if I was a psychic working one-on-one with you.
Él escribió esto hace varios meses atrás.
And we've given these to people in America, and we've given them to people in England, and it's always the same. Thank you so much for coming along and doing this and being honest with it, and I hope this has given you something to think about.
Y hace cinco minutos creía mucho en esto porque la lectura se ceñía a lo que yo, mi personalidad, y cinco minutos después me lo ha tirado todo por el suelo. Es increíble.
Me siento como, yo qué sé, como que me han usado de cualquier manera, ¿sabes? Es increíble la fuerza que tiene la media.
I love this experience. The fact that everyone does have the same insecurities, you don't feel that alone.
We had not gone to the second part, I would have walked away from here thinking that you had psychic abilities.
Nunca gasté ni mi dinero, pero no lo voy a gastar. Y no me voy a sentir escalofriante o no voy a tener miedo para cartas ni nada de esto porque sé que es mentira. Me están tomando el pelo y cuesta mucho. Y es una gran industria.
Well, I could have told you that. More trickery at the same time, 9 o'clock next Sunday.